safety. But if he breaks down, then it's a chance for the Australian to counter-attack.
One.
I think he played the cannon there on the red to the right of the black. Had he got it, it would have been perfect, but it would have been a promising start. That's very good queuing. Generated a lot of pace there and accuracy from on the side rail.
Six.
First ranking event semi-final in 14 months for Neil Robertson. European Masters last season, most recent.
Seven.
Looking to reach his 20th ranking tournament final. And his first since the Riga Masters, which was the first event of last season.
Strange old shot that, because he never played it with enough pace to go into the bunch. I don't know what he played. He played on this red, and it's hard to get on the colour.
Ten.
To the point where he had no shot. What a shot that is, though. Goodness me. There's no way that he wanted to be on that blue from there, from the last couple of shots, but he played it as if it was
15
over the pocket.
Sixteen.
This is a very encouraging start. He looks very positive. I know that he's nowhere near making a break yet, but these few shots have been impressive.
21.
Well, now he's on the middle red here. And the black will follow. So that was a very key shot to finish
22.
Where he did. It's opened everything up in a single shot. Check in to see when the black is respotted, whether it actually gets in the way of the red that's next to it, whether it spots at all indeed, if not up on the green. Sometimes you're never quite sure. Curious now to know whether that red will be available.
29.
That's why I was looking over on the left side of the table, down the line. Can't put it now, obviously, but soon. And again, the black is also still there for him.
30.
Well, the long blue reported was a big shot. It was also a statement of intent. He's confident, he's positive, he's going to attack. It's a good tactic against Higgins, who's a master safety player. Neil Robertson doesn't want to get dragged into that game this evening. He's going to play to his own strengths. show you this blue again. Struck it, 45. Fully expecting to pot it.
This is a little bit of a tester because he didn't want to be this straight on the red. So he's got to force it a touch.
46.
Decent shot. Likely to play the cannon. And the black here. Very good. I must say that this is a very good start from Neil Robertson. He looked sharp.
53.
And, it's 53 break and more to come, you'd say.
54.
Although that, whether it kicked, he didn't want to be straight on this. Annoyance to him, that will be. Didn't see much wrong, but I think it made a funny sound and the cue ball didn't travel through enough. So he's annoyed with himself. If he's a ball's width lower, it's the simplest shot to stand up for a red to the opposite corner pocket. He's very purposely walking around the table. He's near the cushion.
61. But
pretty sure that the bottom red is available because from his looking at the places that he could get on it, he was zipped. And we've arrived at frame ball, and he might still try to flick one or two reds out, even though this is the one he wants.
62.
He looks outstanding already.
Yeah, very interesting start. There's John Higgins won the safety battle, got in first, missed a red on 12. Neil Robertson has stepped in with great purpose here.
70.
And he's looking to put his stamp on the match straight away with a century. This would be his ninth century of the tournament. Marco Fu last year made 11 in winning the event. More importantly, he's punished the John Higgins mistake. That missed red on 12 has been very costly.
Yes, this was the mistake. It was fairly elementary. Dragged it onto the far jaw, which can happen, I suppose. Since then, it's been a barrage of pots all hitting the back of the pocket with a crunching sound in this break.
90.
Well, Neil Robertson is well aware the form John Higgins was in certainly last night against Ronnie O'Sullivan, and he has to play well this evening. What a great start.
99.
Can't ask for better than this. 100. To open the semi-final. And he's shown John Higgins that if he offers a sniff of a chance this evening, he's determined to make the most of it. his 9th century of this tournament so far. Yes, a blistering start to the evening.
Off the red. Certainly enough of the red out there for the pot to be gettable. Oh, what a shot that is. Maybe it was the right-hand side and he whipped the cue ball around this, the back of the black. Tell you what, this is a very confident shot to play. Without the right-hand side, the cue ball would have hit the black. Great shot. All the stats are mounting up against John Higgins here. He's not part of the ball for 46 15. Minutes of playing time. And the no reply points are one shy of 300. Well played.
16.
His top spin to get through and out of the bunch. At the moment, it's all one-way traffic. And what a difference a few weeks with Neil Robertson's form. I actually think he started to play pretty well during the Masters. Got in plenty of centuries in the rounds leading up to the loss to Mark Joyce, who I thought played a blinder to actually beat him 6-5. Again, that's very nicely controlled. Exactly the red that he played on. He finished perfect.
Yes, he knows he can't afford any let-up. He can't open the door to John Higgins at any point. He wants to, in fact, slam it shut.
You know, if he plays the blue here, the blue will have to go, I think, in front of its spot, which slightly hampers blue and pink. Let's see where else it can go. All of the spots seem to be occupied. Regularly asking for just a moment to do exactly that, put it in front of the spot. They should both steal pot, certainly the pink will. Of course, when they're close to each other, it's hard to pop one and not hit the other.
Just going to make sure it's lined up down the centre of the table.
Thanks, Neil. 28.
Very circumspect refereeing there from Peggy Lee, making sure that it's exactly in line again down the middle.
She's a very well-regarded referee by the players.
Well, you might just think about moving that red that's on the black spot that's making things a little awkward down there. Some kind of a finished cannon might bring him on the red. He doesn't want to give John Higgins anything while he's got him in such a vulnerable position. Yeah, that is a very satisfactory cannon, I think. I'd be more than happy with that, glancing it away and landing on it.
42.
Again, he's away with 42 and a few more to come yet. So really, an absolute landslide at the moment, this match, all one way. We know it can turn around, but if he doesn't win a frame going into the mid-session interval, he'll be very worried, I think. Because at least the interval might come in his favour. Right now, Neil Robertson's concentration is as good as I've ever seen it.
Well, he's only really had one straightforward chance, Higgins. That was in the first frame, and we know that that ended pretty quickly when he missed the red. Now 327 points without reply and mounting up with every ball that Robertson pots.
Well, I guess this break will go down as a fairly slow one. It's 8.5 minutes long, but a lot of the time, Peggy Lee's been trying to find out the exact position to put that blue ball, so it's slowed everything down. Well, he really give it every chance. He could be on one up into the yellow pocket. That's, I think, all he has. But the shot was played again 56. Nicely. He will fizz into the bunch. And just one red. And he already knows that the blue and pink go over on the left into the right middle. And that's perhaps what he'll try.
Well, that looks like a frame winner. And this is indicative of how well Neil Robertson has played this evening. There you see it, a couple of balls away from
62.
Securing the frame, barring snookers.
Sixty-three.
he came to the table, I wasn't sure if this was a really great chance. A chance that would make all these.
71.
And he potted a brilliant red, if you remember, to the right corner with side around the back of the black. It was a truly top-class shot from long range.
I think if the Strictly judges were here this evening, this would be a row of tens.
78.
For Neil Robertson.
Well, if it isn't, I'd like to see the snooker 79. That would make them make it this a 10. Because it was barely an error.
Points without reply. The all-time record was set by Ronnie O'Sullivan,
556
in a ranking event by Stuart Bingham, 547.
Yes, I think the O'Sullivan record was against Ricky Walden, wasn't it, in the
94.
The Masters that time when he just absolutely dominated.
95.
This is a very one-sided, a little different to the way that Ronnie plays, but it's very, very dominant this, and there might be many of these supporting Tom Higgins, but you can't help but appreciate the standard that Neil Robertson is playing here. This is just wonderful snooker.
Started the night with a century, goes to the interval with another century, his 10th of the tournament.
...108... ...110.
I must be feeling very good, and he wished he could carry on beyond this fourth frame, but the 15-minute interval will be coming.
113.
And he missed three pots. None of them really helped John. Two rest shots and a double when the frame was over. Every other shot has gone in.
So over 400 points without reply.
122.
John Higgins has done it before, turn matches round, but he's going to have to produce his very best snooker to turn this one round and just keep this man away from the table, because Neil Robertson is on the rampage this evening.
128.
You just knew the black was going in as well.